In this second part, I'm going to explain you how you can record and monitor your ambisonic signal in your DAW. If you haven't watched the first part on how you can connect your ambisonics microphone to your input device, just make sure to follow the first part in the link in the description below. So I have created here an empty Logic session. And the first thing that I'm going to do is to convert it to Dolby Atmos. So I have to go to the mix and Dolby Atmos sections. And then I have to set the spatial audio to be Dolby Atmos. Once I do that, you will see that Logic inserts the renderer automatically. And if you open the renderer, we can choose between the monitoring formats. In this case, I'm going to use the Dolby renderer, which is going to binauralize the audio for me so that you can hear it in YouTube. And the next thing I have to do is to change the width of my track to be surround. And for doing that, I just have to click on the channel mode and set it to be surround. And I have to make sure that the output is set to be surround. And finally, I'm going to set my input to be my surround input. So if I were to put it in record and in monitor, you see that there is audio, but an Ambisonics microphone records in what we call A format. And for working in the DAW, we need what we call a B format. So what we need to do in our first insert is to transcode the signal from A format to B format. Every manufacturer of Ambisonics microphones will provide you with a plugin that you can use for changing the signal from A to B format. You can use our AB transcoder, which is compatible with every single Ambisonics microphone. And for this example, we're going to use the 013 transcoder, which is developed by us for the Soyuz microphone. So the first thing I'm going to do is insert in my audio effects the 013 transcoder. And you can see here that the transcoder has two modes. There is the monitor and the quality mode. The monitor mode is great for tracking or recording because it's going to offer you zero latency whenever you are listening to whatever you are recording. And the quality mode is going to offer you the best quality possible when transcoding from A format to B format. You can change these things after recording or while you record, whatever makes you feel more comfortable. We always recommend you use the monitor mode whenever you're recording and then the quality mode whenever you are mixing. So finally, for the next insert, we're going to have our decoder, which is going to decode our signal from B format to whatever our Dolby Atmos array is. So we're going to insert the decoder. And as you can see here, everything is working quite nicely because now I have the signal. It is receiving my Ambisonics track and is decoding to stereo. But since I want to use the Dolby renderer so that it converts the signal to binaural, I'm just going to change this to be the width of my bed, which is 712. And once I do that, you can see that my Ambisonic signal is being decoded to 712, and it is the Dolby renderer that is converting that signal to binaural. So if we were to try and see how this sounds, let's just check it out. You can hear that my voice now sounds in the center, and if I go to one of the sides and then to the other side, the sound field is being respected and is being kept just as it is. And this is how easy it is to just convert my signal from the microphone to Dolby Atmos using Logic. And now whatever effect I insert between the transcoder and the decoder is going to work natively in Ambisonics. Let's just try it out. I'm just going to insert here one of our effects. Let's just say that we're going to insert a Vortex, for example. And Vortex is a very cool plugin because it's a reverb that works three-dimensionally. So you are going to take advantage of the Ambisonics three-dimensional sound field for creating very, very cool soundscapes. So now I have inserted Vortex. So my microphone signal is going to the transcoder, then it's going to Vortex, and then it's going to the decoder, which is converting the signal to 712. And this is how it sounds.
So if I speak right in front of the microphone, you can hear that the three-dimensional properties of the signal are being kept. And at the same time, I have a very nice three-dimensional reverb, and I can change the settings of the reverb live, and everything happens three-dimensionally, and that's pretty, pretty cool. So this is how
you work in Ambisonics with Logic. If you have any questions about the workflow that I just followed, don't hesitate to ask in the comments below. I will do my best to try and help you out. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.